Hello friends, welcome to Orchard Provec Engineering and Food Processing Private Limited. Today in this video we are going to discuss about floating fish feed making machine and the plant machineries. We will go one by one to all subjects. First, we have to understand many questions which are in your mind regarding the floating fish feed making. Like, what is floating fish feed? Why fish feed is required? Like, what are the recipes for the making the floating fish feed? What are the raw materials used to make the floating fish feed? What are the machineries which are used in the floating fish feed making plant? What are the different ingredients roles in the floating fish feed making? So let us start this video one by one. So let us first understand what is floating fish feed. There are two kinds of fish feed. One is the floating, which floats over the water, and one is sinking, which sinks in the water. So like human feed, floating fish feed is a supplementary feed we are providing for a good growth in a particular time period for a particular fish variety. Like, fish is always there in the water, and there are lot of sources for their feed requirement, like plankton, natural plankton, aeration. But besides this, for a particular time period growth, we need to have a supplementary feed, and that is known as the floating fish feed. The floating fish feed floats over the water. Fish comes over the surface of water and take, and that's the way fish meets its feed requirement, by coming over the surface of water. Now let us first understand what are the raw materials used for making the floating fish feed. So major raw material, like, we have to understand what is the role of floating fish feed, which we have learned that it is a supplementary feed. So for making the supplementary feed, we need to ensure two component in the feed. First is the protein level, and second is the calorie, like the energy level. So we are only giving the fish feed to the fish only to meet out the requirement of protein and calorie. Besides this, there are various medicines which we provide for the good health of the fish inside the surface of water. The major source of protein on the earth, which is a vegetarian source, is the soybean, which contains around 42 to 50% of the protein and 432 kilocalorie of the energy level inside it. So major source is the soybean DOC. Another source is mustard DOC, which contains 28% of the protein level and 330 kilocalorie of the energy level. Third one is the DDGS, which is a byproduct from the rice plant, and that is also having a protein content of around 32 to 35%. This is all vegetarian sources of protein. There are other sources of non-veg sources of protein, which is like fish meal, which contains around 35% to 45% of the protein. Then MBM, meat bone meal, which contains around 42% of protein. Then there are blood meal, which is also a good source of protein. Then besides the protein and calorie, a fish also requires from fiber, which we provide from DORB, which is known as a de-oiled rice bran, which is also having an 11% of the protein content inside it, 11 or 13% sometimes. Then we have wheat flour, which also have 13% of the protein content. Then we have maize, which is already having a 11% of the protein content. One thing we have to keep in mind, that wheat and maize plays a big role in making a floating fish feed. Like, maize gives an puffing to the feed, which ensures a good floating property to the feed. Also the wheat flour, which that provide a carbohydrate surface over the fish feed, which ensures no penetration, no fast penetration of the water, so the feed can ensure no perforation, and it can withstand over the surface of water for a longer time, like 16 to 24 hours. So now these were the main important raw material for making floating fish feeds. Besides this, there is a coating of fish oil over the surface of floating fish feed, and edible oil also. So these 9 raw material are being used for the making the floating fish feed. Let us know the approximate percentage of the raw material inside the floating fish feed. So DORB, de-oiled rice bran, is used somewhere around 38 to 40% inside a feed. Then soya DOC is being used as 15 to 20% inside a floating fish feed. Mustard DOC is used as 7 to 10%. Fish meal is used as 7 to 10%. MBM is used at 3 to 5%. BM is used as 1 to 3%. Wheat is used as 5 to 10%. Maize is used as 5 to 10%. Fish oil is used as 1% or 1.5%. And there are various medicines like sodium bicarbonate, dicalcium phosphate, toxin binder, DL methionine, L-lysine, choline chloride, vitamin premix, vitamin C and gasoline, which are used for the good health of fish. So these were the raw materials which you learned. Now let us know what are the machineries needed for making a floating fish feed. So let us understand one by one. So for making a floating fish feed, you need to have all combinations of raw material in a powder form. So for making a powder from a grain, we need to have a crusher, which is also very popularly known as pulverizer. So the pulverizer is used to make the powder from the different combinations of raw material mix. Further, after making the powder, we need to have a moisture level or the water level inside the feed. For this purpose, we use a mixture in which we add around 15 to 20% of the water inside the powder based on the recipe. Here also in this mixture, we add medicines. So after having a mixture of 15 to 20 minutes or 30 minutes, depend, and then we take this mix to the extruder. In extruder, as you can see, we are feeding the raw material to the feeding hopper, and from there the material is coming to the main screw chamber, barrel chamber, and here it is going through a chamber with narrow gap and coming from a die which is around 1 mm to 4 mm. And here there is a cutting motor which is cutting the feed into the round shape as per the speed which we can vary from the panel. So this is how we are making the floating fish feed. But the feed which is coming from the extruder is having around 18 to 20% moisture, and this is not a good moisture content for having good shelf life. So we need to bring down the moisture, and for this purpose we have to use a dryer. The dryer may be of rotary type or a conveyor type or a oven type. It depends on the capacity of the plant. Further, after drying, we need to cool down the feed till the atmospheric moisture level or temperature level. And further, we will add fish oil over the surface of floating fish feed to have an attractive smell and also an attractive feature from the surface. So this is how we are making the floating fish feed in the plant. So we understand that there are 6 different steps. First is to crush the raw material after mixing. Second is to mix all them together with the water and the medicines. Third is to make the pellet using an extruder. Fourth is to make them dry till 10 to 12% moisture. Fifth is to cool them over the surface or by using a cooler. And sixth is to make them spray of oil over the surface to make them attractive and also a good smell. So by using these 6 steps, we can make a floating fish feed at our farm or a factory. Now the main question is that why there is a need of making floating fish feed at farm or factory. The reason is that majority of the big companies which are in Andhra or different part of India keeps a margin of 5 to 6 rupees excluding the transport for per kg of the floating fish feed. And this is what we are passing to the companies. So this is not going in your pocket or your clique pocket. It is directly going into the pocket of a big company. Now, there is a big myth which was produced by these companies into the people's mind that making a floating fish feed is very difficult. We cannot make the floating fish feed because the machines are very difficult. We have to have a skilled staff to make the floating fish feed machine running. But now it is very much clear that making the floating fish feed is very easy. Only you have to follow these 6 steps which we discussed, and you can make a very good quality floating fish feed at your farm, and you can easily use this floating fish feed for your need, and also you can pass on the extra feed to your surrounding people who are in your 200 kilometer of circle from your village or your district place. So this is how you can help yourself and your society, because The floating fish feed is the costliest item which you are going to provide your fish, and the most of the expenditures are coming on the floating fish feed because you have to get an good growth within a limited period of time. So friends, don't delay and use your floating fish feed plant to make the floating fish feed by your own. And now we will now try to learn one by one what are the different capacities of the machineries. So friends, we have a smallest capacity of 15 to 20 kg per hour of the floating fish feed making machine, which use around 7.5 HP of power. Then we have 20 to 30 kg per hour machine, which require around 10 HP of the connection. Then we have 40 to 50 kg per hour floating fish feed making plant, which is use around 18 to 20 HP power connection. Then we have 80 to 100 kg per hour floating fish feed making plant, which requires around 30 HP of the power connection. Then we have 100 to 150 per hour floating fish feed making plant, which requires around 40 HP of the power. Then we have 150 to 200 kg per hour floating fish feed plant, which requires around 60 HP of the power. Then we have around 200 to 250 kg per hour plant, which require around 75 HP power. Then we have 300 to 350 kg per hour of the plant, which is requiring around 70 to 80 HP per connection. Then we have 500 kg per hour, which requires around 125 HP. And then we have 1000 kg per hour, which requires around 180 HP of the connection. So friends, we have understand that there are different varieties of the machineries available from 15 to 20 kg per hour to 1000 kg per hour. However, on a farmer level, only the machineries from 15 to 20 kg per hour to 200 to 250 kg per hour is successful. Reason being, the farmers doesn't have a big power connection. We have to mention that all these machineries are three phase only. No single phase machineries are there. And the machineries always comes in combination because it is all a continuous process. We have to go one by one. First crushing, mixing, extrusion, drying, cooling, and then flavoring. So we have to follow all six steps to make a good quality floating fish feed. The machineries which we provide comes with 4 to 6 dies, 1mm, 2mm, 3mm, 4mm, 5mm and 6mm sometimes. All machineries have a set of die, and then also it has a set of spares also for screw and barrel. Our machineries can make a floating fish feed ranging from 40 and 5, like 40 protein 5 fat, 30 protein 5 fat, 32 protein 5 fat, 28 protein 4 fat, 26 protein 4 fat, 20 protein 4. So this is the way we can make all kind of floating fish feed which are required during a cycle of a fish, and we can ensure a good growth within a limited period of time inside a pond, bioflock or a RAS. Of course, the quality of the floating fish feed will only depend on your raw material selections. The best quality
of the recipe
can provide you good FCR, good growth and good return over the end of the year. So here in this video, we are showing you a floating fish feed making machine which is of 100 kg per hour and having a 15 HP main motor, 1 HP feeding motor and a 1 HP cutting motor. Here you can see very easily that we are feeding the powder to the hopper, and the powder hopper is coming to the barrel, and further a cutting motor is cutting in different sizes. Here we are making in this video a 4mm floating fish feed. We will also check the floating capacity of a feed. One thing which is in mind of every farmer is the running of floating fish feed plant is difficult. No, friends, I am mentioning on the video that it is very easy to run a floating fish feed plant, and neither you need to have a proper person or a skilled person. Our person will come on your plant and he will run the machineries for 7 days, 8 days, and he will let you learn about how to run the floating fish feed making machine. So friends, I think this video was very useful for all of you to start a floating fish feed making unit. The February season is coming where you will start the fishing. So it is my request to have a floating fish feed plant before February, so that you can have a saving since from the first day of your fishing, and you can save 5 to 6 rupees per kg over the floating fish feed. Now, one thing which is in your mind, what is the profit in a floating fish feed making machine? So let us understand with an example of 28 protein 4 fat feed, which is mostly used in a fish cycle. The raw material for a 28 protein 4 fat feed making comes in around 25 to 26 rupees of best quality. Then we have an expenditure of 2 rupees per kg for manpower, which is having our labor, our operators, and even the management staff. Then we have an expenditure of 2 rupees per kg for the electricity, and then we have 1 rupees for bag and 50 paisa for our management. So this is how 25 rupees of the raw material and 5.5 rupees for all these expenditure altogether. So somehow a 28 protein 4 fat feed we can make in rupees 31 at our own farm, which is available in 43 rupees or 44 rupees for a reputed company, and also in 40 rupees by some local companies. But somehow, if we are going to make it in 31 rupees or let's say 32 rupees at our farm, we can easily save 8 rupees at our own farm. And also, if we are interested to resell the feed to the others which are nearby, you can easily pass on a margin of 2 rupees or 3 rupees to your friends. So this is how you can save your money as well as your friends' money. Well, you need to have a good quality of recipes, good quality of the machineries, and a space of around 1000 to 1500 square feet for making the plant run. And also you need to have 3 to 4 laborers and a good person which has an intention to learn how to run the machineries. So friends, this is how you can run a floating fish feed making plant. So friends, don't delay and start your making floating fish feed at your own farm or factory, and try to earn a profit of average 5 to 6 rupees per kg. And for that only you have to buy a good quality raw material, good quality machineries of combinations, and then you have to run by using a simple person in help of factory. And this is how you can start your floating fish feed making plant. The February season is coming, and the most of the farmers will start fishing in North India, and there are fishing in South India over the years. So this is the best time to buy a floating fish feed plant, and saving, since from the first day you can save rupees 5 to 6 rupees per kg. So friends, if you find this video is informative, is helpful for your business idea, please like our channel, subscribe our channel, and put in comments on the video. Also, you can directly call upon our number 7073642737 by WhatsApp or call, and you can take the information. Also, you may search more information about the floating fish feed making plant over our website www.provecengineering.in or www.pvgfoodmachinemanufacturer.com. Here you may find different capacities plant information. The best way of interaction to call on our number. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe us, and please refer this video to more and more friends so that we can help society.
Gracias.
Thanks for watching our videos. Please subscribe, like and comment our video, and also do not forget to call us or WhatsApp us over the number 7073642737. Also, you may search over our website www.provecengineering.in, and you can find the information regarding various kind of floating fish feed plant which our company Provec Engineering makes. Thank you friends for watching this video very patiently. I hope this video was in line to your requirement, and this is how I can help you in finding a good fish feed making plant. We are there, we are near to you in Pune, Banaras, Guwahati and Kota. You may personally visit our factory and can check the quality of floating fish feed making machineries. Thank you all for visiting this video and watching this video. Thank you all.